In this module, we're going to talk about the App Service Environments option inside Azure. So there's a little bit of confusion here created by the fact of naming. So we have App Service Environments, and we also have Application Services. And so if we can kind of look at the differences between these two, might help people to provision these things a little bit better. I'm going to start off actually in the portal. We have two different options here, one for the App Service Environment and one for App Services. Now, before I mentioned the App Services and other modules, but if we looked at a web app that we have deployed in the App Service, and you can see App Service highlighted here, we basically have options for connecting this thing to private networks. So for instance, if I lay out a scenario, this is a typical scenario. Someone has an application, a web application, and they have a database behind it. That database may be running in IaaS, or it may be running in a PaaS instance. But for argument's sake, let's say it's running in an IaaS instance. So they just want to bring their database up to the cloud, and they want to start using this PaaS model for the web app. So in that case, it's kind of a touchy situation, right? Because the app service that gets provisioned isn't actually inside of a VNet. If you look in the portal here, you'll notice that there's no mention of any kind of virtual network inside of the main settings here, the essential settings for the web app. If you look down here, if you scroll down through some of the settings, though, we actually have this option under the routing section here, and it's under networking. So when you look at that, you say, oh, great, so we actually can put it in a VNet, but that's not true. So these are different types of connections that we can do to other things inside of Azure. So if we had a IaaS virtual machine running SQL Server and we wanted our web application to communicate with it, we could obviously use one of these features to connect to an existing VNet. That doesn't say that the web application itself is actually in a VNet, it's just saying it's communicating with one. So the thing to remember is a web app has a public endpoint bound to it that cannot be removed. So for things like PCI compliance and some of the regulatory requirements around what you can do in the cloud or how you can expose your application, that's pretty loose, right? To say that we always have a public endpoint bound to our web app. We can turn on authentication and those kind of things, but the endpoint is still there. It's not disconnected from the internet, so there's a public binding there. If you take a look at the app service environment, slightly different model. So in there, and I have one provisioned here, you'll notice it's kind of a first-class citizen here with the virtual networking. So in this case, we have a virtual network here that's bound to this thing, and we can actually build our app service environment such that it is bound to this virtual network. So in that case, once we build our app service environment, then we can put our web applications inside of there, and then they have no public endpoint bound to them. You can choose whether you want to. You could add a public endpoint if you wanted to and route it, put a load balancer in place, all these different options for how you kind of control the traffic flow. But from a core sense, it's actually disconnected by default, which is great for like a QA or a testing environment. We don't necessarily want those exposed to the public internet. And as I mentioned before, with some of the regulatory requirements some of these applications are under, we don't want them to run at all exposed to the public. So in this case, we can actually build that and not expose it. So we can choose how we do expose that to the internet. Important case to remember when you're building any of these types of app service models. So if you're building a mobile app or a web app, think about the app service environment and how that might play into, you know, how much you expose about your application. And that wraps the module on app service environments.